evening was meant to be a little jarring. Jesus saying, eat me, drink me. First, the Jewish authorities are wondering how in the world they can use this kind of language, that Jesus can talk about himself this way. And then he feeds into their fears. He's being provocative. This reading is full of provocation. And if it makes you uncomfortable, that's good. That's what it was meant to do. We say that we take the bread and drink the wine in remembrance of Jesus. We look at it as transformational. But when we use vampire-like language, it kind of crosses the boundary. Right? Drink my blood. Eat me. It's like Alice in Wonderland when she finds that little note, eat me, and then she grows 10 feet tall. That's actually a little joke on the transformation of what happens to us as Christians. So we have to take a little back step here to see what Jesus is playing at. He's playing with these guys. They are so critical, he knows he might as well not waste words with them and give them back what they are doubting. Yes, that's right, you need to eat me and drink me. And if you don't understand it, that's because God didn't call you. And that's even more provocation, isn't it? How would you feel if he said that to you? Well, you can't say that about me, right? These are the holy men of the temple. But we have to go back. So let's look at what Jesus says at the beginning in the Gospel of John. He says that I am the resurrection and the life through the water of baptism, right? Through the water of baptism, he is made into a different person, into a different being. The Holy Spirit comes down and speaks to him. This water, then, he talks about with the lady at the well, the woman from Samaria. The meeting at the well is all about the woman from Samaria wanted to give him a drink, and he says, the living water, which I am, will make you so that you are never going to be thirsty again, right? And he says these words, I am, I am. And then, after this sharing of the water at the well, the disciples have been in town to get some food for Jesus to eat. They come back, see Jesus sitting with not only a Samaritan, but a woman Samaritan. They're shocked, they're provoked, and they say, aren't you hungry? We brought you food to eat. And he looks at them and says, no, I'm not hungry. I've already been fed. And they remember, they argue with each other, and they say, well, how can you have been fed? We didn't have any food. That's why we went to town. And he says, the food which I eat is my Father's will. The food that I eat is my Father's will. I live to do my Father's will. I am fed by doing my Father's will. So that was the prelude to this segment on feeding the 10,000. On all these readings that we've had, one after the other, we have one more next Sunday, about the Eucharist and how important it is in the Gospel according to John, in all the Gospels, but especially in this Gospel, where he provocatively keeps saying, I am the bread, I am the wine, it's me. So we have to know that this criticism is out there. It's still things that are said. I've heard people say it to me. Do you really believe that? And we have to answer for those things. So we're the ones that have to wrestle with what this means. Several of the ways that I've thought about this, and we each have our own way. When I was in the Convent of St. Helena, the habit we had, not only did we wear a habit, but our habit of worship every day, was we had morning prayer, noonday prayer, evening prayer, nighttime office, and we had the Eucharist every day. Five times a day, we were saying psalms. We said lots of other prayers too, and we had lots of readings from the scripture. But it was saying those psalms five times a day that something changed in me physically, so that I started to embody the psalms. The words from psalms would just spring up into my head. I didn't try to memorize them, but when you say them, we said the whole Psalter every 2 weeks, and then started it again. And started it again, it begins to change who you are, so that I am not the same person. I didn't try to memorize anything. I just changed by saying those psalms. And we call the psalms Jesus' prayer book. So just our attending these services that we come to on Sunday, the words of the Eucharist, they change who we are. It's not just what we receive in the bread and the wine during the Eucharist. Our whole faith is incarnational. One of the ancient ways of praying was called the Jesus Prayer. And in this prayer, the belief was that we are to pray continually, because we are told that. Pray continually, ceaselessly, pray without ceasing. So the way that some people thought of this was to say a prayer with every breath. If you have to breathe, then you say a prayer with your breath. Jesus, Son of God, have mercy on me, a sinner. Lord Jesus, Son of God, have mercy on me, a sinner. You say it over and over with every breath you take, and watch as your life becomes transformed. Now, these are very crude reminders of how we are changed by what we do. What Jesus is talking about goes so much more than just memorizing and saying words over and over again. Are you reading, marking, learning, and inwardly digesting them, as we say in the collect that comes before Advent? Read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest. Jesus wants to present himself as fully God and fully human. When he is resurrected, he does have a physical form because he invites people to touch his hands and his side. But he is so much more. And what he's offering us through giving his life away for us is that same transcendence. And because he uses the present tense all the time, I am the bread, I am the blood, he's inviting us to completely take him in. Let all of ourselves be full of his presence. And with that presence, we are in the kingdom of heaven. Because the kingdom of heaven is now and will be forever. Amen. It's transformational activity that we're involved in here. Think of how we use our bodies in church. You're sitting, you're kneeling, you're standing. My position up there at the altar with my hands out, this is the ancient position of prayer. It's called the orans. And this is how people prayed in Jesus' day. You get tired pretty quickly when your hands are up like this. But you're also feeling like antennas with our head and our hands. We're feeling the Spirit come in and asking for God to be present in us. And it demands attention. You can't hold this position without paying attention. And Jesus wants us to watch every little hint we get about the living Christ being involved in our lives, through the words that other people say to us, through the challengers of enemies of Christ. We really do believe that that's the body of Christ, the blood of Christ, and we can say whatever comes in the Spirit for us to say. Say our own truth. Yes, I believe that. Yes, I like to read the Bible. Yes, I enjoy going to church. Yes, I like talking about it. Although, as Episcopalians, none of us were taught very well how to talk about our faith. We like to open up the door and let them just come in and see and experience it. And why do we do that? Because, I'm going to tell you why. Because when it's in the context of experiencing the organ, the standing, the sitting, the praying, involving our body in worship, the eating and drinking, we are absorbing with all of our beings what Christ is giving us. Christ, who is still vibrantly alive today, saying, eat me, drink me. Read scripture and drink in the truth. Use the metaphors, but know that it goes way beyond metaphor. It goes into the habits of our everyday life. It goes into what we ask God to do for us and for the ones we love. Every healing prayer we pray, every grasp of power that we need to get us through the day, it is in everything we do. And the possibility of changing somebody's lives is always present. So don't be put off by Jesus' provocative nature. He is provocative. He gives his life for us and challenges us to do the same. Knowing that we are fed in the Spirit with what we need, we can offer our bodies as a gift to others to use as they will. always for the betterment of what Jesus is asking us to do, and through love and charity with our neighbors.